be kept on that which is eternal.
Come on, Pastor Donnie.
And be filled up with that which is temporal. That's the idea. The blessing is not heaven. The blessing is who is in heaven. Jesus Christ. That's the blessing that we will.
Well done, good and faithful son.
Our Lord,
our Savior. Glory, thank you. Yes, we did.
Back.
know what you mean,
Brandon.
Only guys will just tell the truth. Continuously.
Lord, thank you.
Okay, come on.
Yeah, we know they do.
Those things will be revealed. Now, caution.
It's not normal to have questions. Matter of fact, questions show inquiring mind. So if you're the person to see that way, you've got an inquiring mind. Machado, congratulations. And that is a good thing to have an inquiring mind. But we've got to be careful that we don't spend or waste time and ignore that we're learning, trying to find out the answer to something that the Holy Spirit never deemed us to have. So it's not wrong to have a question. You could have questions, but we should not let those questions consume us. That's the deal. We are to be people of faith. We are to understand that as it concerns the Bible, which is the revelation of God's Son, it is the revelation of man, who man was, how we came into being. And the reason why the world is in this mess, and the revelation of God's solution to that mess. And that should be the true focus and desire of the child of God and the study of the Word. But like I said, it's good to have questions. And if you don't have questions at times, I'm not sure you're using your mind. But we must understand there will always be questions. But if the Bible's not giving us an answer, we should park that question on the side with the understanding I'm going to have the knowledge and understanding. Rachel from South Carolina is our first caller today. Hello, Rachel.
Hello, Mr. Dunn. I was trying to talk to some counselors, and I was trying to tell them that you don't pray to Mary, you pray to Jesus. And she got back with this. All right, to pray to Mary. And because Mary intercedes for us, I said, no, the Lord intercedes for us, Jesus. And I started the scripture about Jesus and Satan, and the scripture about how we pray, I thought we started to tell. Did I answer her call?
Well, I'm going to Mike talk to you because Mike would raise God, like he was an altar boy, and he would have played to minister coming up priest. Feel like he is the one that should speak to that.
You did a wonderful job, but what people don't understand is the Roman Catholic is told, it goes back to 1854 with Pope Pius IX, in his Ineffabilis Deus, and it said that all the children of the Roman Catholic Church were so very dear to us, and these words of ours, with a still more honor and zeal for piety, religion, and love, but continue to venerate. Pray to most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, conceived without original sin. Well, she was not conceived without original sin. The Bible said, all has been all children born of God. The only one was Jesus Christ. This puts her in the same harm as Deeds. And so,
I left my water right there for you. You want to go get it from me for me? Mother, you know I can't do that.
Actually teach that Father exceeded Jesus to sin.
Excuse me?
Anything that she makes the request for. But the Bible tells us that there was one mediator between man and God.
Thank you for calling, Rachel. Let's go to Betty. Hello, Betty. You're on the air. Without the Holy Spirit drawing you.
How cruel to you are, friend.
That's very dangerous. That's something that we have to be very careful. You know, the idea, Ricky, would be it's bad enough to tell a lie. But when you bring the Holy Spirit into your lie, it makes it a billion times worse.
That paper in verse 4 tells us, he says, listen, it was your prayer, you didn't have to say. Once you stole it, you didn't have to give any of it. But where the problem lied was that we gave the impression that they gave more than what they actually did. Two, we see the pride was built about some religious pride, and that's what the issue is.
Yeah.
Well, the end. Go ahead.
Well, when something like that may come up, witness to or a family member that's not...
Never, this guy listening how to get up. Never happy, just ready to do evil. He's dreaming of that. Manifesting the life. Always by choice.
losing a foot, a leg, or whatever the case. So it's one of those cases of
I didn't bring any bacon in with me, son. I ate what I was eating in there and the rest of the other.
The hearer of the seriousness of what was next.
And you guess, son. It wasn't enough, was it, Mother?
It's a whining of explaining something.
I agree, son. It's never enough bacon.
Great form.
Yeah, that's the only reason, man. That's what they are. Lord Jesus, thank you. Look at she look at them pictures. Lord.
To listen to the SBN broadcast in Spanish, use the And we need your help to make that up. I know SBN is a blessing to your heart and life. I know that what we provide to you and teach you, put you, and anoint you is a
ministry. Lord Jesus, thank you.
So I know you're passing it off to the Lord. You're asking to help us make up the shortfall. And for those of you that can help, we want to give you one of Dad's most anointed CDs entitled Homeward Bound. The title song is a great song written by Rusty Goodman. You can begin to listen to it here when you're blessed. And secondly, with your gift, we're going to make up the shortfall. So please go to the phone, go online, and help us to make a shortfall.
Fall asleep, back up, do duck, duck, do. Powder peels, it don't matter. They do it. And he know it, he do it too. Come on, Matthew. That's the other one that's posted up on the video. Matthew. Matthew. look at the video too. Nobody called her back. They knew she was on that mess and on that mess. Coming to get her little wanted ass only by the police. This is an evil boy, this badass boy in the book. As they telling him what to do. And he loved to do evil. And those. What you hear is the evil one. Podcast coming soon. Valley Park still in his wife. They gotta clean his behind because his grandmother don't.
Well, that's not true.
Grandma gotta get high. She got high. And he do too. Before you get on that bus, you blow. You have done nothing to him. Just a child of God. But they can't say that they've done nothing to me. They being moved, but they're not going to get away with it, will they? Mother then threw him away. And look what he's doing. Grandma then threw him away. But she called on to him for a check. And a place to stay. But the street don't tell him that. And be his friend. Lord Jesus, thank you. Laughing like the girl laughed it up. Get on over there.
This whole idea that has been presented to you—it's a national identity movement, and it has been.
You know she's talking about her name. Get on over there.
Others have tried to do it from different ethnic groups and everything.
Say that was lunch. I don't need to eat anything until later this evening.
Black people have become Jews, but that can't replace the Judaism that we see in the Bible. For example, we know there was a large amount of people from Ethiopia that had been converted from the queen that had been converted earlier. But that doesn't replace Judaism.
Well, there's a group of Jews. I forgot what African country it was, not Ethiopia.
They love to tell you how much money they got, but they never say nothing about the Lord. Come to what she done, Lord. By the grace of God, I did this. God's guidance, nothing I did. And that's the world. But he got shoes on the stone. Well, she didn't wash up behind any of that. She went and came. So you pass these videos on. They do this.
He
said, who was the one just I made this? I did this. If I don't say excuse me like that, just excuse me. I don't do that on purpose. And you can't say they don't know, because it's been over a year. The management has been told them, they've been written up. This affects the San Diego, which is the same. The pastor just talking about a demonic. If you look at the picture, look at her. Look at her. You're saying pretty baby, no, evil. Well, if you're a child of God, you say evil. And you hear it too.
Beginning in the Old Testament, the Old Testament patriarchs and saints were saved, and Jesus had not died on the cross yet. They were saved because
their faith was in discombobulate.
What the sacrifice of the Lamb represented, which was a Savior.
And thank you.
And when Christ, in his earthly ministry, he operated under the Old Testament law. And so their faith, those disciples, their faith was in two things. What the sacrifice represented, faith in what the prophets had prophesied, that there was a Messiah to come. And when they were introduced to Christ, they recognized this is the Messiah, and their faith was placed in the Him. Now, when he died on the cross, that's when the debt of sin was paid. The blood of bulls and goats, the book of Hebrews.
And there was an accident for them, pure sin, evil. Because they do dope.
The sin. But when Jesus died, his blood that was shed didn't cover the sin, it removed the sin. And so, yes, they were saved. And another way that we know that is because we know there are certain points in the public ministry of Christ.
And he really think he do it. Well, they all think they do it, son. Thrown away from the wound.
He was the only one. There was a season that he put in the Gospels where he gave the disciples the same power. They went out, lay hands on the sick, they saw miracles, and the Holy Spirit cannot and will not anoint a sinner to do the works of Christ.
Okay, Daddy, I'm going to agree with you because I know in the 10th chapter of Luke, when the, I think the 7th of the 7th disciples, he sent out all over the world to heal people, and they came back, they were rejoicing, and they had healed the people.
That's right.
He said, yes, that's good. You should rejoice because your name is our faith. And
that's it.
And also, I read the 17th chapter of St. John, where also it further makes me believe that they were already saved by reading the 17th chapter of St. John. Now, the other question I have is the people that were saved that went to paradise and they died, are they still in paradise now?
No. You know, the Bible said that when Christ was in the tomb, that he went down to paradise. He did two things. He went down into hell. Number one, he preached to the spirits that were locked away. We don't know what was
going on. Would have had to say, boy, you went. Lord, that was a good one.
Paul in Ephesians said he led captivity captive. And that means that he emptied out paradise. Paradise then was a place in the part of the earth. Today, we can use the term paradise as another name for heaven.
Okay. And my final question is, whatever happened to Carl Brower? I don't see him on your show anymore.
He started a church.
Okay, so he doesn't live in Louisiana anymore?
He lives in Louisiana, but he's tied up with what developed and creating and birthing a church.
Okay, man, when you listen, I have all these ways to never try to, I've been listening to him for years, and I will never stop as long as life is in my body. I will not stop listening to Dennis Ryder because he has made a big difference in my life, and because of his ministry, I'm able to go out and witness to other people.
Well, thank you, Annie. Thank you for that, and we praise the Lord for that. Thank you for calling. This question we asked, should we just pray once and believe God has heard our prayer and keep thanking Him instead of praying the same prayer multiple times?
That's okay. Fine, too.
What Jesus taught, He said, pray, ask, seek, and knock. And if you look at the Greek terminology, it's a continuous sense, ask and keep on asking. Seek and keep on seeking, knock and keep on knocking. So there is nothing wrong with continuing in prayer. That's in action.
Well, and look, okay, now I would say, I would add to that the story the Bible gives of the persistent widow.
Yes.
The widow before the judge kept asking.
Also, Luke 11, the individual that came.
Yeah, your importunity, or his importunity.
The blind man came to Jesus, he prayed for him.
He opened the door and gave him as much as he wanted. So it's in that way.
Georgia, you're on the air. Ellen?
Yes, I'm here.
You're on the air. What is
20 years to repent. And if he doesn't repent, there will be no hope for him. That's what that means. It's not God changing his mind. Genesis is him dealing with an individual. He's speaking to an individual.
Oh, okay. So this is pertaining to Adam.
Yes.
What my plan.
Right.
And his score intended pertaining to us today, to man today.
Yeah, if you look at something, Alan, you look at creation, expectancy in the beginning was hundreds of years, up to Methuselah, 932 years.
Yeah.
But then after that, it gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller until at one time worldwide, it was very open, it was going to be 3 or 4. Now it's higher because of the advancements in nutrients and medicines and vitamins and all of that. I think the worldwide, the average age end is 78 years or something like that. And we're seeing more and more people that live, you know, I saw a clip of a man, 106 years old, out jogging.
Okay.
So, you know, it's expanding.
Yeah, you cleared that up because I'm saying one fire Bible is there for 120 years. Then later on it says Greek going.
Yeah, but Genesis 6 is God's warning to Adam that he needs
just
to
don't know for.
Yeah.
Great.
In one spot.
And I appreciate it so much. You're going to do the time. Thank you,
Lord.
Well, why'd they do that with a man who was in the building?
You'd like to call 800-342-8430. This question email, can you have the gift of discernment without being baptized in the Holy Spirit? Michael, start with you.
Well, the gifts of the Holy Spirit are the fact that you were filled with the Holy Spirit.
I feel like the manager was just here.
As you said earlier, there are times that all Christians will have some discernment. But these are different situations. I remember once ministering to somebody in deliverance, asking about the Spirit. Spirit gave me certainly that the person was not set free and only starting to have passed. And sure enough, when I brought that book, I think really did, but you were there. And right away, I said, well, you know, my spirit come out and I'm going to look back again. That was a discerning of spirit, and that's something that we
can
understand each one of the gifts. But it gives the Holy Spirit. It's like a person who's not filled with the Spirit.
And thrown away from conception.
And
double thrown away. The mother throwed them away, grandma throwed them away, but holding on to them for dope. Dope check.
Every Christian will have some discernment, but that with the discerning of spirits will have a special anointing.
Is it the gift of discernment? There's a gift.
Just like she threw hers away.
The gift of discernment is more than mine.
I went to prison for writing bad checks, stealing people's checks, and everything else. And still. And he's going to do the time. Look at the last Thanksgiving, things going out, things she didn't stole. You can buy all that, why don't you go get the baby stuff? It was stolen an item.
Hello, Mary.
The boy said, Mom, be careful. He was just coming taking stuff. Video that
up.
But she gotta go ask the church. To the schools. And run to the hospital using the agency. Advocates. See you all right, man.
Is there any connection? Now, on these questions,
your friends. They get me with that. But who cares? Dope gotta be bought. They buy shoes and say, oh, they're going to roll in a chain. I get you grown having the same shoes year after year. But how does that go with the child? I actually get the same thing this year. The boy's still walking around in red and white shoes. Just foolishly. And not when you're on that mess, is it? But man, you get the right thing.
Seventh-day Adventists, an expose of the religion of Islam, the truth about the Masons, the truth about Mormonism, the truth about Jehovah's Witness. Now, these normally sell for some $30 each, but we reduce the price to just $10 each. Get one, get two, get five, get all of them, ladies and gentlemen. That's what you ought to do. You, as a believer, need to know what these religions stand for, what they teach. This is Jewish Wagon saying, thank you for hearing me out, and thank you for taking advantage of this. You'll be glad you did.
Take advantage of this offer by calling or going online to shop JSN.com.
Can't run for the goat. Yes, she should. And see Mecca going, because she can't go out freely. She wanted by the police.